Hello everyone, myself Omkar. Here I am going to present our work regarding genome sequencing of halophyte Salicornia brachiata. So it all started with one of the major problems in agriculture, that is soil salinity. Salinity stress affected over 6% of global land area, and the area is increasing day by day. This problem affects crop productivity, microbial community, and in turn the agriculture economics. In such case, utilization of salt-tolerant plants can be beneficial. Such salt-tolerant plants are called as halophytes. Halophytes can complete their life cycle in high saline conditions. Therefore, it is important to study the evolution and integral salt arrest mechanism. In spite of having significant qualities, genome information for halophytes is as of now not accessible. Talking about halophytes, Salicornia brachiata is an extreme halophyte belonging to the family Amaranthaceae. This plant can accumulate salt as high as 40% of its dry weight. It can be cultivated for extraction of edible oils and eaten as salad greens. Therefore, we decided to use Salicornia as a genomic research to study salt-tolerant mechanism. We estimated the genome size using flow cytometry, which is to be 480 to 500 MB. Now let's look at the data generated for the de novo genome assembly. We generated short-read data using Illumina HiSeq platform and long-read data using PacBio SQL platform. The data summary statistics is as below. Here we can see the coverage for genome assembly is considered to be good. Here we generated two types of assembly. First is long-read assembly using only long-read data. For this, we used Kanu assembler. And the second assembly is the hybrid assembly, for which we used short-read data and long-read data both. This assembly we generated using Masurka tool. Here, for assembly assessment, we will be looking at three major things. First is N50 value. N50 value basically gives us idea about the contiguity of the assembly. More the N50 value means more contiguous is your assembly. Second parameter is the Busco completeness analysis. Here the Busco checks for the core genes in our assembly. So the Busco score more than 90% is considered to be good. And the third thing is mapping with short reads. The short reads from Illumina are remapped to our assembly to check how much data is covered in our assembly. So if we see here, our hybrid assembly from Masurka assembler has N50 of around 10 MB and number of contigs to be 469. And if we check for the long read assembly, the N50 value is of 20 MB and number of contigs are higher than the hybrid assembly, which are around 1300. For both the assemblies, Busco score and the mapping rate are above 90%. Then we merge these two types of assemblies, that is long read and hybrid assembly, to get a merged assembly. If we see the assembly assessment of this assembly, then we can see that now the N50 has increased to 28 MB and number of contigs are decreased to 409. And other parameters are similar. Now we used optical mapping data to super scaffold this contig level assembly. For this, we used BioNanoSol suit. After optical mapping scaffolding, here we can see a drastic change in N50. It's gone up to 60 MB and the number of contigs are as less as 340. And also the Busco score is above 90%. Then we just polish the assembly using our highest quality short read data, and there are some slight changes in N50 and Busco score. To summarize all these things, as we go on refining our assembly, we got the N50 value to be increased and the number of contigs to be decreasing. So the Basco score gives us idea about the coding part of the genome, while assembling the repetitive part of the genome is the challenge for any genome assembly. So for that, we calculated LAI index for this purpose. LAI is linearly correlated with the content of intact LTRs identified in the genome. So for our assembly, we got LAI of about 14.29, which if we compare with the table above, which is of reference quality. So what does it mean? It means that intergenic and repetitive sequence space is also assembled well with reference quality. Then we move to repeat annotation. For this purpose, we use repeat masker tool. We got around 65% of the genome covered with the repeat sequences. Then we compared the repeat distribution with the closely related species. And here we can see that the distribution is also similar. Then we moved on to the gene prediction and identification. For this purpose, we generated ISO-seq data as an evidence for gene identification. From this ISO-seq data, we generated transcripts from ISO-seq3 pipeline and given it to the Maker2 pipeline for gene identification. Further, we are planning to generate RNA-seq data, which will supplement to these annotations, and also we'll be planning a differential gene expression analysis of at different saline conditions. To summarize all these things, we generated high quality de novo genome assembly of size 469 MB. The assembly is having high N50 value of 60 MB and Basco completeness score of 92%. As we discussed, LAI score of 14 means reference quality assembly. The genome contains around 65% of repetitive genome, and the gene identification analysis is still going on. Thank you all for your attention. This entire project is a huge collaboration between CCMB and CSMCRI. I thank all the authors in this project mentioned here. Thank you.